Hey guys, thanks for stopping in. My video today is, what is myofascial decompression and is it good for TOS or thoracic outlet syndrome? Well, myofascial decompression is just another word for vacuum cupping. And I've been doing vacuum cupping myself for over 4 years now as someone who's had TOS for almost 40 years. This is one of my favorite things to self-treat my TOS. I use it, as you can see, I was doing it a day before yesterday on my shoulders. I do it on my shoulders. You know, you can see both sides. It leaves those purple marks. I use it on my shoulders, on my upper back, my neck. I've used it on my face, my jaw, anywhere that gets tight, and it's worked really well for me. So I'm a huge fan of vacuum cupping. The only people that I see that seem to have are negative on vacuum cupping are usually people that haven't tried it. So do I think cupping is a cure-all? No, I think it's a useful tool. I mean, I do the three things that have really helped me get better and improve a lot in the last 7 years with me and my TOS is vacuum cupping, joint mobility exercises, and self-massage. And I started out with joint mobility exercises first. Then after I did those a little bit for probably a year or two, then I added in a little bit of self-massage, and the vacuum cupping was last. But if you think about it, thoracic outlet syndrome is caused by compression up here, you know, in the upper body. Sometimes these chest muscles get tight or these neck muscles get tight and they compress the nerves and the arteries. And so when you put these cups on, as an example, you put them on, you pump it like that, and that cup is pulling on the muscle and the fascia. The myofascial is, you know, you have your individual muscles, and then there's layers, or not layers, but this web-like stuff called fascia that kind of winds through the layers of individual muscles. So that's why they call it myofascial. It's muscles and fascia combined. So when you leave that on there, it's pulling or decompressing that area. Now, if you leave it on there long enough, I usually leave it on for about 5 to 10 minutes, but a lot of times it will leave a purple mark, and it really gets, it draws the blood through that area. So if an area is tight, a lot of times it will help the muscles relax right away, and it works really well for me. So for me, vacuum cupping has been a great tool at helping to decompress this thoracic area. And I just call it a tool. It's like, it's not a cure-all, it's a tool. Like you know, self-massage is a tool, or you know, joint mobility exercises, that's a tool, or stretching is a tool. I mean, it's just one more thing that I can use in my arsenal of things that really help me. And these are right up there as far as things that help me. These are one of the top things. A lot of people think it's weird, you know, because they see the purple marks and stuff like that, but it really, really helps me, and I'm a huge fan of it. I haven't found any real drawbacks to it besides the purple marks. You might get a little bleeding once in a while. You'll get a little blood in the cup, maybe if you have like a little scab or a blemish or a pimple or something in that area, and it happens, and it's freaked me out the first time, but it's happened, and it's not really a big deal. So then after the cup's been on there a while, you just pull it off. Now, see how nice and pink that is? It's not purple. It wasn't on there very long, but even if you do leave them on for, you know, say 5 or 10 minutes and an area is really healthy, it really won't turn purple. I've been using these on my legs a lot because I've had a spinal fusion surgery a couple months ago, and I have a lot of tight muscles, and I noticed that the skin is pretty pink. It's not really leaving cupping marks on my legs, so that's a good sign. It means everything is getting pretty healthy. Now, my shoulders, that is another case. You can see that they're still real purple, and I've been cupping this area for 4 years now. So for some reason with TOS, thoracic outlet syndrome, this area always gets tight, and even though I've been cupping for like, you know, over 4 years now, it still leaves purple marks. So for some reason that area just seems to always get tight, and it never really seems to clear up. It's kind of strange. I don't know why. I can't really explain that. All I do know is these cups really do help to relax this area, and my movement has gotten a lot better over time. I used to be so stiff, but it's really helped to gradually over time stretch these muscles out. So I'm a big fan of myofascial decompression or vacuum cupping to help treat my TOS. Thanks for watching, you guys. Talk to you next time.